Excuse me. Hello, boys and girls. Mike here. Long go short play. No, this is a doozy. I'm approaching this one with some trepidation because those of you who've played it know what a terrible game it is. And guess who tested it? Yeah. 15-year-old me tested this game in my first 2 weeks at Denton Design in Liverpool on Rodney Street next to the HSBC Bank, I think, or cash machine. It's no longer there now. On the corner, though, when you're going up toward the Philharmonic. Anyway, if you know Liverpool, you know what I'm on about. If you don't, you don't. Anyway, this is where I worked on that game. Of course, your warning lights are going off because this isn't an Ocean game. It's a Denton's game. And they were, respected as they are for the 8-bit era, they were nowhere near as big as Ocean. Or respected as Ocean. But they did do some really quality products back in the 80s. Anyway, Baton Returns for the Amiga. Excuse me while I let the cat in. She has been asking for a while. She's going to ask to go out. She's not going out. It's nearly midnight. So this game, I just want you to know, so far, hello. So far, we haven't pressed the button on the pad. It's gone from the title screen to the pre-game animation. Also, we can't skip it. There's so much wrong with this game. Just in the formula of it, the construction of it, and in the way it plays. And I could have stepped in at any point, all right, as a kid, in my first 2 weeks in the games industry, working with some seasoned, you know, professionals. But I could have stepped in at any point and made them think twice about a lot of this stuff. I will say this, though. Batman Returns, the film, came out in summer 92. It's set in Christmas, but it came out in summer. I think Dave Lombard, you talk about this. I worked on this game in October 93. It was late, really late. Like, it missed the boat late. To the point where so many people are not even aware there's an Amiga version of Batman Returns, whereas the Amiga version of Batman the movie was massive by comparison. It's not an ugly game. And look at this stuff. This is all straight from the movie, of course. And it's very well rendered on the Amiga in 16 colours. This is the first pause point in the game. We're right at the beginning of the level. Let's play it and, excuse me, see what's wrong with it. Are you going to settle? Feel free to settle down at any point, mate. You're softy. Okay. Just shove her out the way. That's our Ginny. We've got three of them, yeah. Here we go. Go on, come down. Don't walk on the laptop. Right. I have cheated, and there's a reason for this. So I'm getting hit, as you can see. But the reason I've cheated is because it's that easy to lose life. That was a life lost. First major bug, let's face it. This game is rock solid. Now, and not in a good way. It is a game that takes an element of tactics. I love the animation, by the way. People complain about this. I remember one review said it. The SNES Batman, for example, which is awesome, let's face it. He looks like Batman. But in the Amiga version, he looks like Michael Keaton in tights. And he kind of does. But I've got no problem with that. The sprites are small, but they're really well animated. I mean, I saw how the animations were made, and they had an actor do the moves. They had, before they really designed the game, a walk animation for Batman, a really slow 14-frame walk animation. I know it was 14 frames because I counted them. it was beautiful, but of course it didn't work because look at the speed of the game. So that run animation is lovely. Look at that. I remember seeing that in Deluxe Paint and thinking, beautiful. Some of the other animations are a little bit campy. Anyway, it's a very standard affair when it comes to the animations. But you've seen, I've already lost three lives just fighting those clowns. Now, that could have been made, a bit easier just by making the energy go down a lot slower. I've got no problem with that sort of encounter. That's cool. As long as it doesn't kill you instantly. And believe me, if you mess around in front of that guy, it does. This sort of fight, this is fun. I like this. I was really enjoying this at the time when I was testing it. As you can see, it's very fast-paced. I just wish the energy, I wish Batman's energy took, 10 times longer to go down. The game would have been beatable, possibly playable, maybe, if that was the case. I mean, look how fun and action-packed that was. Really enjoyed that. Now, this is what I did. See at the bottom on my little icons here, I've got the what they call the bat disc. It's not a batarang, because the batarang comes in later, where they try and recreate the scene from the movie with the dog, you know, it jumps up and grabs it. But when I was testing, one of my bugs, this shows you what I know about testing and what I knew about testing. One of my bugs that I'd written down, look at these beautiful backgrounds, they're really well drawn. I think Ali Noble, who was one of the directors, did these. And they're gorgeous, I love them. Really gorgeous. Yeah, but one of the bugs I put was that, it's not even a bug, the weapons, Batman's weapons looked a bit rubbish. That was my bug too, this is a bit too tough. It just needs more energy. It just needs more energy. Oh, the cat wants to go out again. Sorry about that. It's actually the other one. It's our rose. He just needs more energy. That energy just needs to not drain when he gets hit. See how it's draining? Just, you know, 10 times the amount of energy. That's a lot more, I know, but it takes that much more to make this game. Actually, fun rather than just frustrating. This is a bit frustrating. It's doable. It just takes a lot of arsing around. And as you can see, you can't progress until you've done it. So you might as well knuckle down and do it. There we go. That grid should open. Yeah, I remember us. It's a fun game, is the thing. In its way, it just needed a few things fixing. That I could have stepped in and said, give him 10 times the energy, trust me on this. Like, they wouldn't have trusted me. I was a 15-year-old, snot-nosed kid, what do I know? But the game was so late, they had to rush it out. I remember Konami were giving them grief over it. I think it was Konami. I'm pretty sure it was. I remember having the conversation and just listening in on the real problems of a game developer, you know. This guy's not coming down, is he, for anyone? I really enjoyed it, and I still do, actually, to this day. Except you've got to cheat and have infinite lives on. It's just the way it is. And they have it has a lot of imaginative levels later on. Not that I got to them back in the day, because I kept dying early on and thinking that was okay. It's not okay if you're testing the game and you just cannot get off the first level. That's a problem. If you're playing it all day, you should be able to get off the first level. See, there's technique to these guys. It's a bit renegade-y. Although, I'm not really going to compare this to Renegade. Because that is a better game. Let's face it. So there's some frustrating bits like that which aren't really designed. That guy with the fireballs needed sorting out. And that was just, you know, a comment on a bug list I could have made. Just do something with him to time him to make him not constantly randomly blow fireballs at you. It's not very fair that way. I was more interested in the graphics. And my bug was that the one that was memorable to me, I mean, I filled the page, but was that his weapons looked a bit rubbish. And I remember the programmer, John, coming up to me and saying, oh, I see. Those weapons not good enough for you. Sorry, excuse me, I have the cat again. She's litters out there, so she goes in and out. Yeah, saying, so these weapons not good enough for you. And I was like, uh-oh, I'm in trouble now. I got hard-faced about it and said, no, not really. He said, I suppose you think you can do better. And then he hard-faced it. I was like, yeah, probably could, actually. Need me around deluxe paint. Not so bad at graphics. Anyway, next thing you know, I'm sat in front of an Amiga 600. And he's been really nice to me. And he said, have a go. See if you can do them. He said, to be honest, I drew that. And I'm the programmer. And we just didn't have time for our artists to do any of it. So if you want to have a go and put the weapons in. I was like, you are joking. And I spent so much time on it. I've just selected it. This is my contribution. Now, blink and you miss it. It's not a batarang. It's a bat disc. And I put lights on it and everything. Did you see that? There's another one. Let's see if I can pause the game. I can't pause the game. There it is. I drew that. My first contribution to a video game. Look at the little lights. Got little glows and everything. Just around the side. I drew that. There you go, my first contribution to a video game, graphics-wise. My first art contribution. Uncredited, of course, because who remembers that some 15-year-old who came in for 2 weeks' work experience did that on a game that they've worked on for, you know, 9 months or whatever it was, with all this gorgeous artwork going on in the background. You don't get a credit for doing something like that. Yeah, so there we go. That was my first bit of art in a game. You will find if you try and play this game, if you haven't already, that that disc is totally ineffective. But, oh no, actually, wow, that was quite effective. That it's not as easy as this to play. It takes a bit of practice, and it's very frustrating, and it's very unfun while you're being frustrated by it. Try it with cheat mode off, and you'll see what I mean. I should have picked up on that. I should have said, make this game easier. Just give him more energy, that's all you need to do. I wish the me of now worked on this, or at least just had an influence on the way it played, because I at least had the guts to set it. I just thought, you know, clearly they know something I don't, and this game is going to be better when it comes out, and it wasn't, and it got slated, and it's not a good game. It's a shame, because it could have been better just for that. There is a level later on where the platforming is so badly implemented as well that you end up losing life after life after life, falling off the same bit, and it's really weird. Am I getting hit there? I'm getting hit there. And some of the baddies aren't as well kind of mechanized as these guys are. Some of them are just a bit too fast and thuggish. But you know, these were like relatively minor glitches. This one though, I feel partly responsible for. I feel I could have made this a better game if I had just known what to say. So I'm sorry about that. I apologise for my failures on this game. But I did get to draw a bat disc. And that was kind of cool. Let's see if we can get to the boss. I think the boss is coming up now. It's not so much a boss. It's a scene from the film, if you like. With kind of interactive elements. But I liked it. It was a nice touch. The flying kicks are really satisfying to pull off. There he is. So, he's got a few clowns. So you can kind of go in there and punch in that. And I think it should be more about that. I think I should be able to sort of do a bit more of that. And single hit kind of deaths, where already bounce off after single hits. It's okay. It makes Batman look powerful. But, you know, as brawlers go, you like games where you can get a few punches in before they fall away from you. Not that it's too big a deal. It still feels very very effective when you do connect. I think maybe they should have made it easier to connect. Like you saw, I did a few kicks then, and they just kind of bounce off me because the collision boxes aren't acting as they should. I think the player's hit collision needs to be massive and really, really effective. It's that thing, if you look at my game power up, which I will come to at some point. And you'll see that I make it really biased toward the player like that. But here's one of the major glitches. It doesn't come up very often, actually. I probably did list it back in the day. That is a grapple rope. You fire it, you pick it up, you land, you hit fire. You fire it and it hits the wall behind the clown. And then an automatic sequence happens where the clown laughs at you and you pull and the wall collapses behind him and knocks him out. And then she drops, Michelle Pfeiffer there. Selena Kyle, she drops, gets up, and that's the end of the level. It fades out and goes to the next level. That's a class B progression, stunted. I can't get that. Class A crashes the game. Class B stops your progression through the game. That went out like that. I've just had one go in it, and you've just seen a class B straight away. I don't even know if I listed it. I'm sure I've seen it a few times. I only work on this for 2 weeks and they were rushing it. And I can't accept all responsibility for how bad this game is, but for my part in it, I do. Second game I ever worked on as a tester, wet behind the ears, terrified of peeing anyone off. And it shows in the product we made. Batman Returns, Commodore Amiga. Don't kill me.